we see blockchain use cases are emerging in every single industry, and I'm going to talk about a few industries and their respective use cases that we have seen significant momentum, including investment and the work that many of the enterprises have done. For instance, in banking, we see supply chain and trade finance. We see KYC. The shared cost of KYC is a huge problem globally, and I think blockchain has a lot of potential to address that. We see transaction banking, especially things around payments and digital currencies, which has a lot of momentum, not just from a central bank perspective, but also from creating things like settlement coins, which is confined to a network. In financial markets, we see post-trade settlements. We talk about unlisted security and private equity funds. We look into reference data. We look into cross-border payments and mortgage-backed security as some of the primary industries that are taking advantage of blockchain to remove, you know, inefficiencies in the system. In retail, we begin to see trying to drive efficiency from supply chain perspective, trying to take loyalty points to grow the global networks from a consumer point of view, and we begin to talk about information sharing, which leads to the information around specific goods from a supplier to retailer point of view. In supply chain, we begin to look at blockchain being applied to drive efficiencies from workflow digitization. We look into supply chain visibility. We look into provenance and traceability. We've seen that with food safety. We've seen that with drug safety as primary candidates in their respective supply chain models. In healthcare, we look at, for example, clinical trial management. We look at EMR, EHR, the electronic medical records and electronic healthcare records. We look into mediated health data exchange from healthcare information exchanges as some of the use cases that are embarking on blockchain to, again, speed the cycle of business and create new business models. In manufacturing, we have seen a lot of momentum around, again, supply chain, product parts provenance, and maintenance and tracking, which leads to a lot of cost around recalls and around product defects, and understanding some of the underpinnings in terms of the cost of those defects and recalls. In government, we look into central bank issued digital currencies, we look into asset registries, we look into digital IDs of every citizen in ensuring that we are curbing the cost associated with the linkages of the digital ID to digital assets as the ecosystem evolves. We are trying to primarily go into fraud and compliance and reducing some of the anti-terrorism rhetoric that comes from movement of money due to opacity of information or identity and funds. In insurance, industry is embarking on blockchain to be able to look into complex risk coverage, looking into benefits management, looking into asset usage history, claims filing, as well as leveraging the insurance industry-specific information sharing to reduce the industry-specific risks. So these are some of the usage of blockchain in different industries we begin to see emerge, which leads to our understanding of the fact that blockchain is here to stay. It's for real, and we have to understand as to what we need to do to make ourselves relevant for that industry.